Hello, and welcome to another iRecord tutorial.
Okay, now we're going to go over an employment outcome and just a little bit of difference that goes along with that. Just so a little bit of background, everyone's required to have an employment-related outcome within their service plan. So this outcome number one would be Alan's employment outcome. We're going to go ahead and we click on that. We see all the information here. So we have, he's getting his whatever his procedure is. It's going through Medicaid, who's providing it, the start date. This is kind of what it looks like as a finished service. So I'm going to show you how that would look, kind of putting that in. So we'll just put maintain employment at Rite Aid, that's where he is currently working. Okay, and the biggest difference here that we want to remember, we check this off, is you want to check off this briefcase because what that means is it's an employment-related outcome, and that'll make sure that all the requirements in terms of the ISP employment-related outcome requirements are completed, and that won't kind of keep popping up. You can have multiple employment-related outcomes. For instance, if that person is doing career planning like this individual is, if that person maybe is already has a job and maybe they're looking for additional employment or something like that, you can go ahead and have employment outcomes of all different varieties under the same plan if you need to, depending on the individual. But the important part is you need to have at least one. So that's going to be your main difference. And then just like your other service plans, you're going to go in, you're going to pick the service. It's going to be support employment. You'll see that there's a couple different options here. You have support employment individual or support employment small group. If this was an employment outcome related to career planning, you would click career planning or pre-vocational training. Sometimes somebody might just be getting more information or being introduced to certain types of employment. Maybe they're going to work on that in their day program. Maybe they're going to work on that in community inclusion. So really, this goal can be kind of interpreted based on wherever that individual currently is. The expectation isn't there for somebody who has no information about employment or, not really that much experience or no experience at all to the next day, just go ahead and get a job. We want to meet that individual where they are and build them up to and provide them with whatever they need that's going to get them there. If that person says they're ready for employment and they want to jump right in, we're going to go ahead and we're going to click supported employment, individual or group, whatever's going to be appropriate for that person. The payment source is again going to be Medicaid. You'll see here that DVR is also an option because, as I mentioned in previous webinars related to employment, if an individual says, I want to get a job, they have to go to DVR first. And at that point, they would receive some pre-placement services through DVR, or if they're not eligible for those services, they can come back and they can use their budget to support whatever that employment goal might look like. So you can have a couple options there. A person could also have an employment outcome and they could be working and maybe they don't need supports. So we can go ahead and just put natural or something like that, because it's not actually coming out of their budget and we don't really need to provide funding towards that. But for now, we're going to say this person needs supports and that we are funding it through their budget for our purposes. We're going to hit Medicaid. We're going to focus on the PCPT for that. Okay, we're going to go ahead and find their provider. I think currently I'm just going to go with their current provider is Bayshore Fitness and Wellness is providing that service. We're going to click SE individual because that's the service. The location would be that person's going to be in the community. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to click the community there. We don't need to share any of the medical information with this particular provider. Maybe it's just not necessary, but maybe we're going to go ahead and we're going to share the PCPT with that provider. Okay. The next case. Again, we're going to fill out these details just like we would for any other plan. If that person doesn't work on weekends, we're going to go ahead and exclude weekends. And let's say they don't work holidays. We can go ahead and we can click on that feature. So this person, let's say they're working maybe 20 hours a week and maybe they need 5 hours a week of supported employment, we can go ahead and that would be 5 units. So we're going to go ahead and do 20 units of supported employment, which over here kindly does the math for us to make that 5 hours. It's going to already do the math for us, put together the budget. And down here, especially for employment stuff, we might say, all right, they're going on vacation one of these weeks. So what we do, let's say they're going on vacation this week, they're not going to get any units that week. And then we'd go ahead and we'd save that there. I'm not going to save it in this plan because it'll blow out that person's budget because they already have supported employment. I just wanted to show an example.
And that completes this webinar. If you have any further questions regarding this topic, please feel free to refer to your iRecord 3.0 user guide.